Hi, I'm Lisa Oland.
And I'm Stacy Lonsky.
We're here at the Indianapolis Zoo.
And you're watching Doing Indy.
Come on, let's go get Daddy. Sweetie, it's time.
It's time. That means it's February 2008. That means Doing Indy's back. Oh man, I've been asleep for like 2 months. What am I gonna do? I mean, I've got so much to do. I've gotta get new clothes. I've gotta contact all the people. I mean, I gotta shave. I have a beard. I've got so much to do in so little time. I don't know how I'm gonna get it all done. Oh, what am I gonna do? Think, Seth, think that. I know. I need a montage.
Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you gotta hang tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna happen.
Yeah, it's time to start Doing Indy. Hi, everybody, and welcome to the first episode of Doing Indy Season 3. You know, last year we told you that this season's going to be all about the kind of stuff that we think is cool, and we want you to show us your Indy, which means that we're going to go out and grab just random people and have them take us around and show us what they love about Indianapolis. Well, we got this email while we were on break from our good friend Lisa Oland, who works here at the Indianapolis Zoo, and she said, Seth, why don't you guys come out and cover the Dolphin Encounter, where you actually get to get in the water with dolphins? Because, see, most people think that's as close as you can get right there to the dolphins at the Indianapolis Zoo. But you can actually get closer. And we're going to bring you along on the Dolphin Encounter on this inaugural episode of Season 3 of Doing Indy. So hey everybody, on this episode of Doing Indy, we're right here at the Dolphin Pavilion with two great people, Lisa, who is a friend of the show that you guys have seen, and Stacy, who's new to the show, and we're actually going to get the true dolphin experience, which, lo and behold, you can too. That's one of the best things about Doing Indy. Every time we do this show, and everything that we do is something that you can do. Now, first of all, I got to tell you, I'm a little uncomfortable because I'm packed in. I never thought I would fit in anything more constricting than my wedding ring, but I found that in wearing a whatever the suit is called, a skin suit. So, first of all, I've got that going for me, but then we come in here, and you forget all about that stuff when you actually get to swim with the dolphins. And you guys, this is really a true, I guess, blessing that we have in Indianapolis, isn't it?
Oh, definitely. I mean, it's a blessing for us that we come to work and we're surrounded by some of the most wondrous animals in the world, right here in Indianapolis.
And this is a really unique experience that a lot of people don't know about, but you offer all the time that anybody can come and do, right, Stacy?
Definitely. I mean, we're the only area that contains a dolphin interactive, and it's a really great experience. People love to come here. They don't have to go all the way down to Florida. We have it right here in Indianapolis, and it's been a big hit since it's opened.
What does having this in Indianapolis mean to you?
It means a lot, because when you're in a landlocked state, you know, you don't have the exposure that other people have to, you know, the coastal regions and the animals and things that you find there. And even just to do this as a job, you know, a lot of times people come to us and they think you have to even just go to school, you know, by the coast, you know, down in Florida. It's like, no, you know, I graduated from IU. This is the one place, Indianapolis, where you can work with dolphins. And then walrus, there's only a handful of facilities that even have walrus. And one of them is right here in Indianapolis.
For me, it was nice. I used to work in Florida. I was able to come back to the Midwest and be closer to my family and work with more of a wide variety of animals. We have new and exciting things coming all the time, and one of our big things here is the dolphin interaction. People love to come here, and just to see the joy on people's faces is very rewarding for me as well. I mean, it's a great experience, and a lot of people just don't realize how big these animals are.
What are some of the things that we're going to get to experience today that, again, like I said before, anybody and everybody can experience when they're here, and some of the things that we're going to learn?
We do get in waist deep with the animals, and we like to show off their body parts, especially the things that maybe you can't see up close in a show. Like their different facial features, pinhole-sized ears. You get to see their blowhole up close. And dolphins, it's really cool because dolphins not only breathe through their blowhole, but they make all their sounds or vocalizations through it. Look at their teeth, and you know, just looking at them through the glass, you won't see that. But up close, we even let people touch them, so you can see them and feel them and really, you know, get a feel for all the different body parts of the dolphin. We also do a lot of high energy behaviors so that people can do some of the same different behaviors that we do in the show. Some of those high energy things, those jumps that everybody thinks are cool in the show, we let people ask for those too, and then get to reward them, to feed them. So we try to make it really well-rounded that you're learning about dolphins, you're having fun, and developing that real love of dolphins, and a deeper understanding about them and how each animal is very unique, very different from one another.
Well, it's time to go. We had a great time here, and as you can see, I mean, everything here is so awesome. And the best part is you guys can do it too, because all the stuff that we do on Doing Indy is everything that you can do. So if people want to know more, what do they need to do, and where can they go to come and experience what we just got to experience today?
Well, if they go online to indyzoo.com and they know the amount of people that want to participate in their session, we have calendars up there, and they enter in the number of people that will be with them, and the calendar will let us know what's available to them, and then they can choose their times. Now, it's not available exactly to everyone right now. We are starting to work on getting wheelchairs into the water with our dolphins and getting them more safe for them as well.
So wheelchair persons can actually at some point get in the water too.
That is our long-term goal.
Yeah, but that's one of the things that the Indianapolis Zoo does. It just sets itself apart. And again, it's just a great facility. It's a great place. So, hey, it's Doing Indy Season 3. This is the opener. Could you ask for a better opener? I say no. So for Doing Indy, I'm your host, Seth Hancock. And remember, in Indianapolis, it's always so easy to do so much. You just have to get out there and do something. See you next week. We're going to swim with dolphins today here on Doing Indy. And I'll tell you what, I love me them fish. First of all, they are delicious. Okay, here we go.